the entire country. Initially, it was restricted only to the northern and eastern part of India. Now we are replicating this in the entire part of the country. We are also extending the vulture conservation to other species other than gyps. And we will be in this project having large number of vulture conservation breeding centers. At present, we have only 8. We would like to increase through this project the vulture conservation breeding center in the country. We would be creating more number of vulture safe zones, as well as for the first time internationally also, sir, we will be having a government sponsored vulture rescue center in the country. All these are proposed in the new revised National Vulture Action Plan 2020 to 2025. Sir, I would take the opportunity of thanking our Honorable Minister of State, who as always has been very supportive, and through his encouragement and inspiration, the promotion of wildlife conservation in the country is going toward the right direction. We also thank senior officials like DG and all my colleagues in the ministry to take kudos and credit for all the good work that they have been doing in order to consolidate species conservation, especially the bird conservation, and in order to enable us in taking forward the bird conservation in the country in the right manner and in the right direction. Thank you, sir. I would be requesting respected Dr. Sanjay Kumar, Director General of Forest and Special Secretary, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, for his opening remarks. Sir.
Honorable Minister of State, Sri Babu Sapriyoji, my colleagues in the ministry, Saldana Sota, S.P. Yadav, Amit Malik, Rakesh Jagania, scientists from various centers, my colleagues, other colleagues in the ministry, from the state government. We have gathered here today to celebrate the 124th birth anniversary of Dr. Saleem Ali. We have been hearing this name, Dr. Saleem Ali, since our childhood. And this name has become completely, I would say completely, synonymous with birds, ornithology. We cannot think of birds without thinking of Dr. Saleem Ali. And that's the kind of great influence Dr. Saleem Ali has on the science, the biological science as a whole. He started talking about ornithology when the rest of the world was considering keeping of birds as an exotic profession, or for the poorer people and for others, they were the source of food, meat, particularly. Nobody was actually talking about ecology of birds at that time. And he became the pioneer of ecological study of birds in such a manner that now we understand that without conservation and development of birds, perhaps the productivity of our lands, whether we talk of agricultural crop productivity, we talk of forest productivity, we talk of the productivity of the wetlands, we talk of the nutrient cycling in the seas, in our wetlands, we talk of fish population, on which a huge number of global population is dependent. We are all connected to the science of birds now. And the credit goes to Dr. Saleem Ali that he popularized this concept in such an early era that now the science of world ecology is very well established. Now we know that what is happening, and we could see that the ministry actually has taken very concrete strides in that direction because of all the knowledges which have gathered around world ecology. Our AVG has just mentioned the action plan on vulture conservation, but I would also like to mention the Convention on Migratory Species Conference of Party, which was held earlier this February, in which again the central flyway for the birds that was discussed very prominently, and our country agreed, our ministry agreed that they will be providing a leadership direction to the management of central flyway zones by establishing various centers and also providing initial facilities in that regard. We understand that bird ecology is facing critical challenge because of climate change. There are various reports which say that the range of most of the birds, particularly those which are temperate birds which migrate to tropical areas or tropical to temperate areas, is actually getting higher and higher in terms of latitude. And that the range is becoming more closer to the breeding ground. So that's a very, not only very important trend which is being discerned, but is also a matter of great concern that once the range and the breeding grounds are not separated properly, then perhaps the kind of breeding which takes place and which would sustain large populations of birds, various bird species, which is very important for maintaining our planet, actually, the life of our planet, that becomes very challenging. And we wish that our scientists, the Indian scientists, the global scientists, they will be working towards that. Particularly, and finding out solutions to these problems which are being posed by climate change. With these words, I once again thank our Honorable Minister of State, Shri Babu Supriyoji, who has been a constant light and constant guide for us on wildlife matters. His keen interest on wildlife matters keeps us to push to new directions, to new heights, and we are very thankful to you, sir. Thank you, sir.
The legendary bird man of India opened up ornithology for the masses. Dr. Ali is no more, but his legacy lives on. The ministry has made a small film on the legend to pay tribute for his contribution to ornithology. I would request permission of the chair for the launch of the film.
Another way.
The trumpeting of the damsel cranes signals the onset of winter and the annual arrival of winter visitors. Asia. They arrive in thousands. Some migrate over the Himalayas, crossing mountain ranges at an altitude of up to 30,000 feet. India is one of the most popular winter homes for migrating birds. Thousands of international bird watchers arrive to watch the annual migration. Over 350 migrating species have been recorded across the country. All possible due to the contribution of one man who brought the world of birds into our homes. In India, there are thousands of places where migratory birds come, halt, roost, and then fly back. India is proud of its rich biodiversity. With just 2.5% of the world's landmass and only 4% of fresh rainwater resources and 18% human population of the world and 18% cattle population of the world, still we have maintained more than 700 national parks, sanctuaries, and we have made real impact in world's biodiversity because we have 8% of it. We always think nature as part of our life. It's a coexistence of human and nature. Salim Ali was a great researcher and a scholar. His 124th birth anniversary will be celebrated on 12th November. We celebrate this as a World Bird Day. That's my wishes. Thank you and all the best. Dr. Salim Ali was born in 1896. One of nine siblings, he lost his mother when he was barely a year old. He was three when his father passed away and was brought up by his uncle. Seeing his keen interest in birds, his uncle introduced him to his friend at the Bombay Natural History Society, BNHS. Ali was barely 12 years old and he started helping out at BNHS after school hours. He wrote his first book in 1941, The Handbook of Indian Birds, followed by 13 others in several languages. The books are popular all over the world and in great demand even today as guides and reference books. His interest grew into passionate pursuit.
On every visit of mine to Flamingo City, I have found a few lessers scattered amongst the hordes of their larger relatives. Now here at last, hundreds of lesser flamingos with their nests and chicks. A wonderful sight. The first authentic record of their breeding in the Indian subcontinent.
He visited the London Museum, Germany, and many other places in Europe. Birding groups have sprung up everywhere in the country. Groups of birders and enthusiasts visit local wetlands and forests on weekends.
To be like a glorified zoo. They don't realize that a sanctuary is merely a conserved natural habitat where birds will come if assured of adequate food, protection, and nesting facilities.
And the legend lives on. Dr. Salim Ali. Birdman of India.
was a short film that ministry has made. So the government of India had formulated the National Action Plan 2006 on vulture conservation for 3 years. The action plan provided strategies action for containing the decline of vulture population, especially three chief species: oriental white-backed vulture, slender-billed vulture, long-billed vulture. So the revised action plan for vulture conservation 2025 has identified priority actions and additional action points for the conservation of vultures. Vulture conservation action plan 2020-25 advocates prevention of poisoning of cattle carcasses with veterinary NSAIDs and carry out safety testing of new veterinary NSAIDs on vulture prior to commercial release. It talks about institution of a system which automatically removes a drug from veterinary use if it is found to be toxic to vultures with the help of DCGA. It proposes to establish additional vulture conservation breeding centers in the country, in Uttar Pradesh, Tripura, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, and 4 rescue centers in different geographical areas. For example, Pinjore in North India, Bhopal in Central India, Guwahati in Northeast India, and Hyderabad in South India. There are currently no dedicated rescue centers for treatment of vultures. It is also proposed to launch conservation breeding program for red-headed vulture and Egyptian vulture, and establishment of at least 1 vulture safe zone in each state for the conservation of the remnant populations in that state. The plan advocates coordinated nationwide vulture count involving forest departments, VNHs, research institutes, NGOs, and members of the public to get a more accurate estimate of the size of vulture populations in the country, and creation of database on emerging threats to vulture conservation, including pollution, animal extinction, unintentional poisoning, etc. So the standing committee in the 59th meeting held on 5th of October 2020 has recommended the action plan. I would request Honorable Minister of State, Shri Babu Supriyo Ji, to launch the National Action Plan for Vulture Conservation in India. So Dr. Salim Ali's timely intervention saved the Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary and the Silent Valley National Park. In 1990, SECON was established at Anaikatti, Coimbatore, aided by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India. He once said, "My hand reels at all these nomenclatural metaphysics. I feel strongly like retiring from ornithology if this is the stuff, and spending the rest of my days in the peace of the wilderness with birds and away from the dust and frenzy of taxonomical warfare." So he was unconventional. Honorable Minister of State Shri Babu Supriyo Ji is also a similar unconventional politician and an avid animal lover. His passion and care for animals is unhidden. I invite you, sir, to deliver a keynote address.
Good afternoon, everyone. With me in this room on this great occasion when we are launching the action plan of culture conservation in India between 2020 and 2025. I welcome Sri Sanjay Kumar, DG of Forests and Special Secretary of our Ministry, Sri Swamitra Dasgupta, ADG, Forest Wildlife, our Ministry, Sri Yadav, who is the Member Secretary of NTCA, Mr. Amit Malik, Inspector General of Forests, Wildlife, MOFCC. All other dignitaries sitting with me in the room, I know all of you are putting in a lot of hard work to ensure that the goals that we have set for ourselves are met with diligence. Scientists who have joined us in today's video conference, respective representatives and colleagues from different states, I welcome you all on this day when we would love to share the happiness with you that yes, we do have a very solid roadmap in terms of how we want to go forward, and the government of India is actually making some very conscious efforts to ensure that this very important part of our nature, of our well-being, of harmony in nature, which is created by the presence of birds around us, is upheld and is healthy and part of our lives in the manner it should be. And I think the best way to do that is to do it on the birth anniversary of Dr. Salim Ali. It is on the 12th of November, but it's happy, it's advanced happy birthday to the best ornithologist. Actually, everyone has spoken about his contribution towards making people aware about what is the importance of birds and how we can contribute towards their well-being as the as human beings started encroaching different areas, which were part of their happiness. The population increased, the forest cover, now we have resurrected a lot. We are one of those 8-9 countries in the world where forest cover has actually gone up. But there was a time when the forest cover was really that of danger. It was not doing very well. Our data did not reflect great stats, and that was a time when this awareness, it created a lot. It contributed a lot towards people doing what is right, and thereby the government taking the right step to play as a catalyst towards an entire endeavor. Birds existed for as long as it is, but to make people aware of the dangers that we are causing to them, but by being careless in the manner we are, treating nature, the way we lead our lives, the kind of waste that we generate, they all contribute towards birds because they are, they feed on that, and it goes beyond saying the amount of contribution that birds have in our lives. We get into the topic of vulture, which is what we are, the action plan that we are launching today. But we know that birds are a very significant part of our ecosystem, and we really want them to sing in happiness and not languish in the plethora of mistakes that human beings do to not make them happy. In spite of the fact that we are all aware how much they contribute towards the pollination, pest control, maintaining overall balance in the ecosystem. What is very interesting to me is that India, with its species richness and diversity, is also blessed with several species of birds, both resident and migratory. But what is very, very important to me is, out of the 1,317 bird species that have been recorded in India, 72 are endemic. When we say endemic, it means that it originated and that is basically their home. So India, I can say, is the home of 72 such unique birds, and it is our responsibility to ensure that, you know, they are kept well. We don't need to, the birds are such free creatures, we don't need to take care of them individually. They know how to take care of themselves. But still, you know, the kind of atmosphere, the kind of air, the kind of measures we take in other aspects of life definitely has a direct impact on them. Like, we know, while we launched this, you know, the second action plan, which is between 2020 and 2025, we know that there was a time when, during the 90s, around the 90s, when I wouldn't say that we were conscious about it, but it was so found out that the presence of a chemical called diclofenac, it's diclofenac, right, in fertilizers or in cattle feed, in fertilizers for crops and all that, which is then eaten up by the cattle and their carcasses, they had residue of diclofenac in it, and that was absolutely poisonous to vultures. And though, you know, even in my childhood, I remember we used to see vultures roaming around, and, you know, they, even if they did not pick up the carcass or of a dead animal lying somewhere, just by the revolving of the vultures in one particular area made us aware of a presence of any such thing. And many a times it may not just be a carcass, it would be something even more than that. So we saw that in our younger days, but today that scene is somehow, we don't see that very often. In fact, we really don't see them in big cities. And therein I think that the importance of legendary people like Dr. Salim Ali, who had created this awareness and worked diligently towards it, he has been given the second highest civilian honor in India, is a Padma Vibhushan. And I think that the title of Birdman of India was given to him just because of the fact that he created that awareness and educated himself and then imparted that education amongst the people around him to ensure that this movement to secure birds and our consciousness to the fact that such a concept of being careful about birds living around us can actually be imbibed in people. So it's my great pleasure to also announce that yes, the government do have a huge roadmap ahead. We have a total of 554 sites in India which have been designated as important bird and biodiversity areas, of which 219 areas are outside the PA network. What is PA?
Protected area network.
There are so many abbreviations that it's better I ask it right now. So if people on the other side of the camera are hearing it, even they might be helped or you know, get it, while I also learn a few of the abbreviations which I may not have, you know, I can identify on this page. So we also know that India also is an important part of the Central Asian Highway and is part of the 30 countries that are part of the Central Asian Highway. And in the world, I think there are about 7 such flyways, which have been 9 globally recognized bird flyways. And we have actually launched a national action plan for conservation of migratory birds along the Central Asian Highway. And India would now play a really lead role in making sure that, you know, whatever we have discussed in this regard is actually put into practice. And we are, and may I tell you that the process has already started. The ministry, as Mr. Dasgupta has earlier said, and I reiterate that, the ministry has also taken initiative to save critical endangered species, not only vultures, but also several other birds which need a special care to ensure, like sparrows. We don't see them anymore, but they have been part of our folklore. They have been part of our daily lives. So therefore, I think we have an action plan to ensure that we can get them back into our ecosystem, in our surroundings. So we are doing a lot, but as I must say that still a lot needs to be done, a lot of awareness, and just not awareness, a lot of action needs to happen on the ground. Whatever we are doing, it needs to be done with more vigor and more sincerity to ensure that this action plan is correctly implemented on the ground. And therefore, everyone who's present with all of us here in the VC today, I would plead and I would request all of you to please put in your very best to save and to, you know, conserve the lives of these very innocent creatures who sing but cannot actually speak, to share their problems with us. We speak, even if we don't sing, we can speak and share our problems and spell it out. But the birds, they just sing for us, they fly for us, they create beautiful, beautiful sights for us when we see them, colorful birds. And as I'm myself personally very fond of them. And I'm also very proud to say that the gentleman who was known as the Birdman of Calcutta, who was born in 1888, Satyacharan Laha, he was a very close relative of mine. It's from his house, which was in Amar Street in central Kolkata, that we actually saw macaws and Australian cockatoos and African grey parrots and all of that, sun cormorants and all of that, and understood that, you know, birds can actually be so colourful, but then they need to be preserved, they need to be taken care of in a very special manner. And all of you are aware that today we are much more educated in terms of ornithology and what needs to be done to keep them good, to keep them safe and sound. So let's practice that. Let's take this endeavor forward with the same vigor and the same sincerity that we have done and we have followed during the action plan 1. So once again, I wish all of you all the very best and thank you for being present in today's VC. I hope that the launch of this book, you will not only get a roadmap but also several guidelines and ways forward. And please give it a look. It's a pretty looking book and it has a lot of very informative things inside which will help all of us. Once again, I pay my humble homage to Dr. Salim Ali, the Birdman of India, and I am very very happy that on his to celebrate his birth anniversary, we have actually chosen and we can celebrate his birthday or his anniversary by releasing the action plan 2025 for conservation of vultures. Thank you so much, Mr.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your enlightening words. So Dr. Salim Ali wanted that the future generation should enjoy the same fun with wildlife conservation that he had. In his words, sir, he said, "I suppose I have done my bit. It's now for the younger people. It's now up to you, younger people." So now I invite Dr. Amit Malik, IG Wildlife, to deliver the vote of thanks.
A very good afternoon to all. It's indeed a privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this very, very important event which we have just commemorating the birth anniversary, 134th birth anniversary of Dr. Salim Ali. First and foremost, Minister of State, Baba Supriyaji. Sir, we have been always guided by you in matters, especially of wildlife. In the ministry, also you have taken a lot of interest in matters which are happening in states. Sir, on behalf of the ministry, on behalf of the wildlife division, on behalf of the entire bird conservation community, we would like to thank you, sir, for gracing the occasion and also giving such good observations with relation to conservation efforts being done by us. For today's function, we have DG sir, Sanjay Kumar sir. He's also been a constant guidance and also has been very closely giving his inputs as far as wildlife conservation efforts are done across country, as we constantly are in touch with between states and also at the division level. So we thank you very much, sir, for being part of this function, embracing the function. I would also like to thank SP Yadav, sir, who has been also a member of the task force of this Vulture Conservation Action Plan, which was released today. Sir has also been for many, many years in with the tiger conservation. And sir, I thank you very much for having agreed to be here and raising today's function. I would also like to thank all the institutes, scientists who are dedicated in the field of bird conservation and research, and have also joined today in today's function. A very special mention for BNHS, Dr. Vibhu Prakash, who has been the director of BNHS, for being present today along with us, and all his team and his in the institute for having contributed and are being a symbol of bird conservation in the country, and having outreach to the students and all those who are in the field. I would also like to thank the media division for bringing out at very short notice this short film on birds and on celebrity as we commemorate the birth anniversary. I would also like to thank all member states, all states who are putting in a lot of efforts in the field of bird conservation and biodiversity conservation, which actually protect habitats and in turn help the country to conserve the birds which are endemic as well as migratory and other birds. I would also like to thank the all members who have joined from the ministry as well as from states, all officers, all other institutions participating in today's video conference. Also a special thanks to NIC for putting the video conference and also the IT team of the ministry for putting the video conference happen in today's function. Thank you very much, one and all.